Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Back to Basics. I probably should change that intro because back and then back to basics sounds a little awkward. So I'll do my best to make it like, hello and welcome to Back to Basics. In the future. Anyway, so today we are currently cooking our iron and we are going to go mining a little bit before it becomes daytime. Let's go ahead and check if we need anything else. I actually thought about something we do need. We're going to take two iron here, and we're going to go ahead and make our first set of shears. Shears are done in this pattern. They can be done diagonally either way. You'll still get shears no matter what. So we're going to get shears, and shears can be used to collect quite a few things in Minecraft. To start, you can get wool off of sheep. You can also get wool off of sheep by killing them, but then they don't regenerate that wool. Another thing is you can get leaves off of trees. What else? You can cut down vines, I believe, and I think you get pieces of those vines. Do it for the vine. I ain't gonna do it. And we're gonna keep it so that we can get wool and hopefully create a bed so that we can actually have a new spawn point, and then we can go out and try to find a new home, because that's really what we want. We want to build a nice new home. I made a bad choice. We need torches. I forgot. So we're gonna go back. We're gonna go back up, and we're gonna make some charcoal. I'm just worried that mobs are gonna spawn down there, but no big deal. Maybe we'll put a door at the top of the staircase or something, or a way to make sure we're safe from the. There's a skeleton out there. Oh, hey, look at the moon. The moon's going down right now, so that's awesome. Sorry about that. I don't know, because the moon's going down and the sun is coming up. Do we stay here? No, we don't. Two skeletons right there. We'll just let them be. So we're going to go ahead and put some of this away. Let's go ahead and... Ooh, we actually ran out of wood, so we're going to have to go collect more wood. I think we should build a new pickaxe. Or a new axe, I apologize. Because... Then we will collect wood faster. Remember, this is one less damage than the iron sword would do. I believe, once again, that means it does 2.5 hearts of damage, and the iron sword does 3. Let's go ahead and save some of our things in case we run into a problem. Let's go ahead and hit some of these guys, so maybe we can get some bones or something off of them. And we get a little bit of experience, of course. Obviously, you can see that skeletons will not burn if they're in water during the daytime, because obviously if you're on fire, you can't be on fire if you're in water. Today we are going to collect some of these trees. Let's hope this guy doesn't shoot us while we're doing this. And we have another goal for the day, which is starting farms. Remember, we picked up those melons last episode, and I'd really like to get that started because food is necessary, and because I don't plan on breeding animals right away, farming is the second best option to that, I believe. It was added in 1.8 that now sheep will drop mutton as well if you kill them. That's only if you kill them. You do not get mutton if you shear them. But like I said, we are going to leave like cows like that. In case we do want to breed in the future, we're not going to kill all of them in the area. We're just playing the safe game. And we're just going to keep collecting a little bit more wood. I don't really know how much we really need, but it's better to be safe than sorry. What are you looking at? Look over there. Yeah, that's what's up. You gotta keep the cows in line every once in a while. I can show you the shears as well. If you do this, see? Now we have a... oak leaf block. See? And those oak leaves will only stay if there is a piece of wood in the area. I believe it's 8 blocks. No, it's probably a little bit less than that. But yeah, like you'll see the trees that we cut down a little bit earlier. Those are creepers. Creepers are mean. We'll probably have to end up fighting them. Anyway, oh, and trees have a chance to drop apples as well. Apples cannot be farmed like melons can. They do drop from trees, but they have a random drop rate, obviously. I'm really afraid of that guy coming to get us. Should we just go get him? Yeah, we'll pull him towards us. Come on, come on. Ow, ow, ow. That's not nice. I gotta go. Okay, so remember, we are getting those saplings, and remember, we replant saplings so that we don't need to go very far distances in order to... cut down trees. We want to keep this area fertile with with our saplings. See, we keep getting more and more. And if you plant them all, you will have like more trees than what you started with, which is awesome. These are flowers. If you don't know about flowers, lilacs obviously are purple, if you can't tell. They can be planted and then bone mealed for more of them. Or you can take them and you can put them in your inventory, or your inventory crafting area, and you get dyes from flowers. Now, dyes can be used to dye different wools that you would find off of sheep, as well as clays if you find them in certain biomes. It looks like we need a new chest here. I would like to make a chest we haven't had before, so let's go ahead and... Oh, actually, we can't because we don't want... Oh, I don't know. I think we can. So we'll just dig out this dirt. Okay, nope, I was right. We can't do that. We'll just fill that up for now. The kind of chest I wanted to create was a double chest. I think we can do it here, actually. Yeah, we can. Let's look it down. And see? And now we have another... Sorry, I was making sure we closed that door. I was a little bit scared that we hadn't. Let's go, so we can drop more materials into here. We can hear that skeleton burning. Oh, we got an arrow from the skeleton that we had killed earlier. That's very cool. We'll keep the wood on us. Let's go ahead and eat up so we don't starve. If you starve, you actually start losing health and, I believe, a little bit of speed. I know if you have only 3 things of hunger left, you can no longer run, which is obviously not good if you're running away from the bad guys. I'm just taking a look out here for some sheep. Hopefully we can find some. Let's go hop in our boat and go down the shore a little bit that way. See if we can't find any. And we'll pick up these saplings as we go. Saplings as well can be used in a furnace, like logs can. And I believe leaves can do that as well. They're all burnable materials, even though they don't obviously give you as much rewards as you would get. Oh, there are some sheep right there. As you would get for coal or charcoal. Like, it won't give as much cooking. Like, that's what I mean by boats are very sensitive. I bumped into, obviously, we got 3 oak logs and we got 2 sticks. So now we'll use our shears and we'll right click on the sheep and we get their wool. Now, their wool will only regen after they eat a piece of grass. I don't know that we'll catch one eating a piece of grass here. I'll keep an eye on them, but we'll just get as much wool as we can. We'll kill one of the sheep just so I can show you what mutton are. I thought I saw a couple more over here. If I did, we will shear one more. And yeah, we'll shear this one, and then we'll go take care of his friend that's all alone. It's for the sake of science, so it's okay. Let's go. Come on. Don't run away. It's okay. Hi. We'll take you. See, so there we go. They drop 2 pieces of raw mutton and a little bit of wool, I believe that one dropped. And that's what sheep are. There's another melon over there that we can see. These are jungle trees, by the way. Jungle trees can either spawn in a 2x2 or a, that's oak, or a 1x1 area. Jungle wood is used to grow cocoa beans. I'm not sure. And these are vines, by the way. You can climb up vines like you would be able to climb up ladders, which I have not shown yet. And they will stop you from falling and taking damage as well. Here we go. Let's go back over here. I think we'll head back to the house. Did any of these regen? No. Let's go ahead and take these cocoa beans. I don't know what's faster. Axe is definitely the fastest for taking cocoa beans down. And these right here, I looked right past and didn't say anything about them. These are mushrooms. We'll take a few of them too because they're nice to have. They are used in mushroom stew. If you have mushroom stew, it actually fills up your hunger quite a bit. So just keep that in mind. You need another type of mushroom. Plus, you need to make a bowl, which is just that recipe right there. You get 4 of them for it. And the mushroom soup, it's not the hardest to obtain, but it's worth the effort if you can start like a mushroom farm. Otherwise, it's a little bit impractical. So if I see some like in a mine, I probably won't pick it up. Unless it's the other type of mushroom, then I will, and I'll point it out to you guys for sure. Let's go. Come on. We're stuck on the shore. There we go. In the water. So we're just going to go right on back home. And we will show you the crafting recipe for the bed. There's obviously squid out here. Squid drop ink sacks. That's the way you get black. That's like, you know how the flowers have different... Come on! Don't go away. Is you know how flowers have different types of dyes? Well, the ink sacs are the black dye, or the that's how you get black wool and things. So let's go ahead and make a bed. A bed is simply just three pieces of any kind of wood, and then wool on top. And that will make your bed. You can make as many beds as you want, but only one will count as your spawn point at a time. We'll go ahead and clear out a little area here for our bed. We obviously want to be able to get in and get out, so. And then boom, there's our bed. We right-click it. It says you can only sleep at night, which is not a big deal. When nighttime comes, we will definitely do so, because we don't want the bad guys to spawn. It skips over all that good stuff. And then so, as well as we have some cocoa beans, which we could probably go ahead and plant. But first, I wanted to make our farm. Now, in order to make a farm, you need tilled land. And in order to make tilled land, you need to make a hoe. So let's go ahead and make a hoe. We'll use an iron hoe. Let's hope that we don't die with it, because then it would have been a waste of iron. But it's okay. There we go. And it's time to farm. We got our next achievement. Let's go ahead and check that out. Time to farm. And then what do we have? We have turn wheat into bread. Awesome. And the lye. So we got to build cake. Awesome. Let's go ahead and go outside. Now, water is an interesting mechanic in Minecraft. It has very odd, like, flowing properties. But I think I have a shovel in here, actually. I apologize. We'll grab that as well. We'll flatten out a bit of land, and then I'll give you a demonstration of a farm. Now, a farm will... water, like I said before, will spread out to 8 blocks. But a farm's water will spread out 4 blocks in each direction. So by that I mean with one source block of water, because it needs water to be a moist land. It needs water, right? So it'll be 4x4. So we can go 4 away from this. So that's perfect, right? And then we can fill that up. And then we can go 4 away from this. Like that. And so we just need to make a perfect square. It's actually a 9x9 if you make it into a perfect square. So we'll go ahead and do that, so that we can make our farm as efficient as possible. Remember, we picked up those melons, so that's what we will be growing for right now. But in the future, we'll obviously find... I just remembered those creepers here, and I got really scared. Anyway, we'll try to find some wheat. Actually, I think we might be able to find some seeds right now if we go ahead and hit this grass right here. This is tall. This is not tall grass. Tall grass is 2 blocks tall. This is just grass block. If you hit these, you can sometimes find yourself some seeds like that. See? And we have the seed drop. And with those seeds, we can plant them in the tilled ground once we have that going. But let's go back to the dirt, and we will finish filling out this area. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice. So we just got to finish off this corner. And then we need to make one more row on this side. We are 2 grass blocks short, or dirt blocks short. Let's just go ahead and grab 2 more. No problem. And boom. Now we will mine out this middle block. And now, how are we going to get water from over there to over here? Well, I'll show you. I come back inside, and remember how I showed you to make the bowl earlier in this episode? We are going to do the same thing, but with iron this time. And we are going to end up with a bucket. The bucket can be used to transport water. It can also be used to get milk from cows, which will help cure ailments that you may run across in the future. It looks like it is turning into nighttime, but see, as you can see, we set down the water. It is turning into nighttime, so let's go ahead and grab our first night of sleep in the bed. There we go. Isn't that awesome? So now it's daytime again, just the morning. Let's see what that dialogue said, because we missed it. That is about the achievements. My bad. Sometimes it says, like, your spawn point has been set here and things like that. But yeah, now if we die, we will spawn where that bed is instead of where we spawned right in the beginning of the map. See, and now we'll till this land, and you will see that it's wet. And that wetness, or I believe it will become wet. And that wetness is due to the water. And now, like I said, this is the largest area that you can have. See, here we go. This is the largest area you can have with one source water block. So let's go ahead and till all this real quick. Now, you used to be able to get seeds from tilling the grassland. I'm not sure if that is still a thing in 1.8. I don't know if they moved it to just those grass blocks. Oh, and that's another thing I need to teach you. If you jump on this, it'll turn back into regular land. Oop, I did not mean to do that, so we'll just jump on it and turn it right back. Now remember, we do have melons growing. So the ideal situation is that we would want the melons to not ruin the fertilizer, right? Or the tilled land. So we're gonna go ahead and collect some more dirt here. A little bit of sand, because you never know when we're gonna need it. We'll collect some more. There we go. And then we'll use this dirt here to make it so that hopefully the melons that we have will grow onto these pieces of dirt, and they will not ruin our tilled land. I don't think we need much more dirt than that. I think we'll be okay with that for now. Now, when melons grow, they can, depending on their location specifically, they can grow with 13 ticks, or they can grow with 3 ticks, or they can grow with 7 ticks. It really depends. I'm trying to get the seeds into my hot bar. It really depends on how, like, fertilized land is, if there's more, or not fertilized, I keep saying that, how saturated the land is, or if there's more saturation to a certain, like, direction, like, if they're surrounded by, we lost a seed, that's okay, if there's more, like, wetlands near it, it will grow faster, and now ticks happen randomly within the game, or each block tick happens randomly within the day. It's on average about 68 seconds between the ticks, but like I said, they are random, so there's no way to predict that. It's just a rough estimate. And it, like I said, they need 3 to 13 ticks, depending on how good the land is. If the land is not wet at all, I believe it's 13 ticks. And if it's saturated with a bunch of other saturated pieces by it, then it will become 3 ticks. But it still obviously takes a bit of time. We'll go ahead and store some of these saplings. We'll store our mushrooms. We'll store our raw mutton. There we go. We did a lot today, actually. It's very awesome, because now we can go on our next step, which is going on an adventure and hopefully letting this food grow a little bit. I think I'm going to call it there for this episode, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please remember to hit that like button. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And let me know down in the comment section below if there's an area of the game that you would like me to cover, because I'd like to know what you guys want to see. Thank you once again for watching, and you have a nice day.